Hey, Frank, let me just talk about Ottawa fans for a bit, because, you know, if given the chance and they would have told you and a bunch of buddies to go to Ottawa to see the game, you wouldn't be alone. But here's the thing, not only fans are coming from Toronto to cheer against Ottawa over the years, I mean, even from Toronto or even, you know, Kingston or Peterborough, they're doing the same thing in Montreal, coming to Ottawa for cheaper tickets. And Ottawa doesn't have an identity sometimes, you know? I mean, they've been burnt four times in four playoff series against the Toronto Maple Leafs, where they probably had the better team and were Stanley Cup contenders. There's a lot of pissed off fans in Ottawa. Show us, you know, show me that you...
I really think it comes down to financing and money. I'm not going to question the loyalty between an Ottawa fan. You know, Toronto Maple Leafs, you know, all of you guys know, that the Toronto Maple Leafs are very, very corporately lucky. Mm-hmm. Corporately lucky. That means that the corporations have supported that franchise, all the boxes, all the cash, and that's why the tickets are sold. All of them are sold. Do you follow what I'm saying to you?
When you went to a game...
Ottawa does not have that corporate fundamental foundation of business.
Right. When you went to a game, you were talking
about the Senators, and on top of that, it trickles down from the big guys, the big guns that own the boxes, that have boxes, very lavish boxes, and I know many of them, and you know, we have a box there corporately, but then it trickles down. I know a lot of smaller businesses. Builders, construction workers, guys smaller that have four in a row, three in a row, eight in a row. So those tickets are all sold. The majority of tickets at the ACC are corporately sold.
Right. Okay, when you went to a game 2 weeks ago against Washington, Bill Waters' son got you the tickets. You and Gemma went. What did they say?
Those were not Bill Waters' tickets.
Okay, all right, I digress. How much did the tickets say they cost? Just your
I didn't pay attention because they were a gift to me, and okay. I sat in second row.
But they must have been
second row platinum against the glass.
$340, $350, lower.
I just explained to you that I did not look at the ticket stub.
I'm curious what they would be.
Price was. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, they'd be up there.
I think platinums are face value are about $500 now.
There you go. Jesus Murphy. Same in Montreal, you know. And again in Ottawa, I'm not trying to, you know, downplay. Peter Fotherington called Ottawa the city that fun forgot. And when you grew up in Ottawa, I mean, they just got the team 25 years ago. There were all the Habs fans and Bruin and Leaf fans. That was, they all lived in Ottawa. So it's tough for them to win them over. And that's, I think that's why the NHL is going.
I disagree with you totally.
Really?
I know a lot of people in Ottawa, and I wish Tony House was here. I believe that Ottawa has the fans. But a lot of the fans don't have the resources to go support the team financially. I really believe that.
Well, it's fallen right on the front page tonight. Jeremy Roenick went nuts on the Ottawa fans this morning on the air. But that's Jeremy.
You know what? Either you want to go to the game or you don't. You know, it's not going to be Jeremy Roenick. You know what? You can't convince people to spend their money if they don't want to spend it on something. They don't want to spend it on this game.
Yeah, but also, Terry, they can see the game on television. And Ottawa, you've been to Ottawa, Gallagher, sure you've been to Ottawa many times.
You bet.
People love watching their sports in bars.
I know.
Go down to the market. Well, there's a million sports bars.
Yeah.
When this team is moved to the Glebe, downtown area, a lot of this stuff will be resolved.
And there's word of
and
that.
I'm convinced, again, Ottawa Sports and Entertainment Group, which bought the Ottawa Red Blacks because they wanted property, didn't want a football team. When they buy this team, and I'm telling you they will, a lot of this will change because the whole corporate identity will change. This is Eugene.
I think that's a valid point. And, you know, Jeff Hunt's a very, very, very dear friend of mine. And he's been very smart with the Ottawa 67s. He's reached out to a lot of corporate sponsorship. He's been very successful as running a Junior A team, which most Junior A teams do not make money.
Yep, and
we just appreciate and value, and he's done very well for himself.
I'd be curious to know how long it's going to be before Eugene Melnyk sells this team, because right now you're seeing as good as it is, he's not getting full value for it.
That's
so
right.
Why would you want to own it for much longer? Just sell the team.
They love Mr. Melnyk because. Even strangers Even strangers reached out when he needed a liver transplant.
Well, he paid them. He paid them handsomely to get what he wanted because he could afford to do it. He's a nice guy. He stuck by that team when no one else would, but it's time to get a new owner because you know what? He'll get handsomely whatever he invested into probably four times, five times the value. But if you
I say he will get back 100 times over his original investment. So if I subtract the losses over the years that he's had it, I would say he's going to end up gaining at least 72% profit.
So, Frank, if you had the team, he bought it at a fraction of the price, he's lost X amount of dollars over the years, would you not sell it, like, right now, realizing?
It depends. I would sell it if I was not cash flow rich, which he's not, and he's had his issues. So if you're asking if I was him in the condition that he's in, yes, I would sell the team in a heartbeat and get my money back and live happily ever after and just ride into the fucking sunset and suntan my balls on some beach.
I have a visual
so,
image.
So what would be the reason why he wouldn't sell it? Because you know there's a buyer.
Because right now he doesn't want to sell it. If I had cash, a lot of cash flow, and a lot of the guys who own these sports teams are very, very rich and they have massive amounts of access to liquid cash, then I wouldn't sell it. So I really don't know what's behind it. I don't want to dwell on what he's thinking and what I'm thinking. I just want to say that I wish all the people of Ottawa and the Ottawa Senators good luck tonight. I'm just going to change the gears again.
Hold on, Frank. Has there been any talk about breaking ground in downtown Ottawa for arena?
I have not heard.
I haven't
either. With what Perry said, the sports group that bought the Red Blacks, that also own the Ottawa 67s, which Mr. Hunt is part of, I believe that they have their eyes set on a huge multiplex, multi-functional main arena that will house the 67s, house the Ottawa Senators, and possibly have a part attached to it because it's big enough, and the Glebe is the most expensive and the most sought-after area to live in Ottawa. We'll have condos and pop, 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 and all that shit. So, you know, I don't know. Maybe that's what's going to happen.